I'll just get the obvious, just let you go nonstop about Taysha and Ivy, and I'm sure you could go today, tonight, tomorrow, next week, next month. But I've got to ask you, just what can you put into words about how special they are?
You know, I kind of really been thinking about this because it's, you know, probably like them. Yeah, I don't think we can put into words the legacy that they'll leave for this program, the belief that they had in this program, you know, before, you know, there was another championship, before there was all those things, you know, and especially for Ivy, I think, you know, being a Miss Basketball and us being able to get a Miss Basketball again was a big deal for us. And I think she just really believed that this would be a great fit for her, and just really excited about that. And you know, she's came here and went from, I think, averaging 3 points her freshman year to all conference and leading in so many categories. Most important thing is who she is as a person. She's led this group. What her and Taysha has been able to do this year, I know their stats and stuff speak for itself, but just to put this team where we're at right now in a position and lead this young group and players that have never been in those positions before, with Creech and, you know, Sydney came on well for us last year and did a lot of great things in the tournament, but she's never been in this role before. And then you had a lot of freshmen. So what they've done, I can't put it into words, but I'm just very humbled and I'm just so honored to be their coach and, you know, to watch how much they've grown over these past, you know, 4 years.
Michelle, I'll let this be my last one, but with each of them, was there a specific point you remember? They're special. I know I've got someone special. Do you remember that point about each of them?
I think when I signed both of them, I knew that. I think we knew as a staff because they both had something that would bring something huge to our program and get us back to where we needed to be, I think, in conversations of top 25 program, things like that. And so, and then it just really flourished when they became as close as they were their freshman year. And, you know, they became inseparable off the court. And you know, if you're close, that's why chemistry is so big. If you're close off the floor, then it really helps you when you're on the floor. And I think that they feed off each other and they help each other grow.
It's a little more special for you in the fact that you recruited them. I know that you recruited Kendall and Mike a bit too, but you went and found them. Ivy was here, but then, you know, Taysha was in Georgia, Lake Park, finding her. Just a little bit more special even for you as the coach that this moment is coming tomorrow night?
Well, I think it's really special for our staff, and especially Coach Collins and I. Because we've been here the whole time together. We sit down and we put a plan together on what we felt like we needed to do to help this program get back to where, you know, we were recognized in, you know, not only in the state, but, you know, in the nation of who, you know, you can't have all the history that we have and not be in a situation to be in conversations about being a top 25 program. So we sit down, me and I did in the beginning, and we just looked at the way we wanted to play, the people we wanted to bring in, and the things we wanted to do for us to be better. And so those two were, they started it off for us. So, you know, like you said, Kendall and Michael. Michael was already here, already signed. Kendall was a late addition in a situation where, you know, I knew someone to get her, but you're right, those two were, I think, our first two that we really sought after and really recruited, went to everything. We went to Ivy played volleyball in high school. We went to volleyball games, went to basketball games. We were at everything, so they knew how important they were to what we were trying to build here.
Coach, obviously it's going to be a very emotional night for both Taysha and Ivy, but for you, how tough is it going to be able to see them step out on that court one last time here?
Yeah, it'll probably be really, really tough for me. It really will. Just for, you know, the same thing that Elliot just talked about, you know, to build a program and be consistent as we've been, you have to have people that believe in you. You have to have people that believe in your vision, even when things might not look that great. And I think that is what's going to be the hardest for me, is because those two always believed from the beginning. Even when Ivy was struggling, she still believed. She wanted to know, you know, what she could do her freshman year to get better for her sophomore year. You know, Taysha, the same thing. You know, what do I do that have to get better so I can help this team get to where we need to? So it will be, you know, but also understand and know when, you know, you're very fortunate to coach and coach great players. Those players are going to walk out one day and they're going to graduate. But I think the best thing that I try to do is make sure that I'm giving them everything they possibly can to be equipped for the world when they leave.
Last home game tomorrow night also brings the opportunity to go undefeated in conference play at home for another year in a row. Is that something that you've discussed and brought to the team just as an extra motivation?
I think we talked about that in the beginning of the season. I think we came back and revisited our goals at Christmas. Haven't talked about it now. You know, we're just going into this game and trying to finish out definitely. I think because it all ties into one. Last senior, you know, last time Tayden and I will be on the floor. You know, the last conference game, all those things, you know. But I think at the end of the day, we're really trying to focus on making sure that we do the things so we can take care of business.
Playing really good right now,
aren't they? Yeah, they are. You know, they had, you know, they went on the road and won in some tough places. And, you know, they're playing really well. They're athletic. You know, and they have a big on the inside that's very, very athletic, likes to block shots. But they get up and down the floor. And, you know, Charlotte's always giving us games every time we play them. So, Kara's a great coach and does a great job. And, you know, but at the end of the day, we got to try to figure out a way to protect our home court.
Split with them last year. I mean, has there been a common factor in those games that have made it so tough for you all?
You know, I just think that, again, she does a great job with the way they play. You know, this year's a little different compared to the way they used to, but they have similar, you know, they're athletic. They have long wings and guards and people that can shoot it. Have an unbelievable point guard that can pass it or shoot the ball or get to the basket. So I think when you have all those intangibles, they have different options. And the teams that are successful are the teams that have different options. It's not just one or two players that, you know, do the scoring, you know, like us. And in order for us to be great, we're going to have other people step up also, too, and like we have in all our other games.